Hi, welcome back to another week vlog. I'm just about to deliver the yearly giveaway PC, which we... It's actually a shame on me. I mean, we did the giveaway, I don't know, like 4 or 5 weeks ago, but I was still testing some stuff with the non-K system, which is in there. So it was a bit of a delay, so sorry to the winner, but he already, I mean, he knew everything and he was already in the email loop, so he was aware. But we had a small delay on there. I'm just about to deliver this to Case King so they can ship it out to the winner. At the same time, going to pick up a water-cooled small form factor build they made at Case King. Could be quite interesting with an external Mora. And that is the rig I was just talking about. It's a quite interesting configuration, and also, as far as I know, this was originally not supposed to be online in the shop on Case King website, but yeah, might end up there. It was only made as a concept, and I think could be a quite nice system just for quick temperature and noise level testing. I don't even know exactly what's sitting inside, so we will definitely find out. And in case you're wondering about why I'm driving with the TTRS from Cora, that's mainly because my RS5 is currently at Audi, because I have to change my tires to summer tires, also have to get my brakes redone. Actually the third time at like 50,000 kilometers, which is just way too much, but yeah, that's the way it goes. But I will now go to Audi, and yeah, they also work on my GTR right now, so maybe we can get a look at that at the same time. And in case you're worried, no, I did not have an accident or anything like that, but the thing was the wrap. And the wrap on this car was getting about 3 years old, and I was reaching the lifetime end, or like the end of lifetime of my wrap, because it was like coming off from some edges. I think it's also due to the fact that we have a lot of climate changes in Germany, like winter is quite cold and summer is quite warm. And then due to the like constant changes in temperature, it was getting pretty brittle on some edges and was, yeah, like coming off on some parts. It did not look nice. And generally speaking, I'm also, I mean, if I look at my phone, I'm also not a friend of like phone cases, simply because I like how a naked phone feels. And for me, it's the same thing with cars. Like touching a painted surface is so much nicer and also looks so much more high quality than anything that's wrapped. Like on top, you can see there's still the wrap on there, still has to be removed. But generally speaking, I think having a nice paint job is certainly better than having a new wrap. And also financially speaking, a new wrap would be something like 3 to 4,000 euro. And that's the same cost, like doing the wrap twice costs the same as painting the car. And if I think about, I would have to like redo the wrap now and then redo the wrap again in like, I don't know, 3-4 years. It costs the same as just painting the car. That's why I decided to just get it painted. Well, getting most of it painted, like I said before, they will not paint the engine bay. I decided that's not worth the hassle, also not worth the cost. I mean, you just don't see it, I don't care. And so they will just paint all the other areas that are visible. Like if you open the door and everything inside, they will still take out the seats, take out the roll cage and everything. Yeah, obviously paint everything that's here visible in the back. Yeah, looking forward to the result. I'm very curious how this will look like in the end. Here we have a few more parts, like the front bumper, for example, some side skirt parts, and like front lip, probably it's in English, like the carbon lip. And those also have to be painted, and especially for the front bumper, there's some pretty like bad things. You can see that the paint came off on some parts. I'm not sure if that's caused by the wrap or if there was like a material defect in the front bumper, so that would have to be painted anyway. Same goes to those like grayish parts in the front. I know it's quite dusty right now, but there are also a lot of like, not sure how to call it, like imprints from stones when you drive fast and you get the stones to the front bumper. So there are quite a lot of dents inside the front bumper as well. So that would have to be painted anyway. So that, yeah, now makes sense after owning the car like 5 years, that getting some parts painted would certainly make sense. And like the side skirts, for example, those are like in this like metallic gray thing. They will stay exactly in this tone. The rest of the car will be changed, but this will stay the same. And for example, also on my carbon front lip, you can see that I hit some parts here, like not really hit it, but hit the ground because the car is pretty low. And then because of the front lip, sometimes a bit difficult. We have some more parts laying around here, like my front door. We have the front fender, which has the Nismo cutout. So it's not an original Nismo part. That's why we had to do the cutout and then enter the original Nismo part in the front fender. Also the hood or bonnet. Not sure what's the correct word in English, but it's like just freshly grinded, lapped, I'm not sure, but prepared for the paint job. And then we have the rear bumper, and on here that's also quite interesting. If I'm not sure if that's visible on the camera, because in the center that's still quite white, but going in this area, which is like directly above the exhaust, it's pretty like yellowish. And that was because I was driving, let's say, an optimized exhaust in the past, which is not the case anymore, because I changed to the Capristo exhaust, which is using 4 cats, and yeah, no issues anymore. And also because I'm driving with ethanol right now. But yeah, in the past I think I got quite some damage on there because of driving like the optimized exhaust version. Okay, but let's go back to the system which we just picked up from Case King earlier. The base of this system is a Jonspo A4 SFF case. Never used this so far, no experience building in this case. I generally don't have much experience with SFF builds, but what I straight notice is that this part right here, like this entire surface or like part, that is custom made. So that's not there originally, but very, very clean build for the VGA. Also quite interesting that they put 3 seems like 60 millimeter fans on top, probably for cooling like VRM parts and stuff. That is quite interesting. So even after removing the second plate from the side, the second glass window, there is not much to see. Like this is also a custom made shield from what I can see, like a custom made cover to hide everything that is sitting underneath, and only the board and the memory sticks are visible. Everything else is pretty well hidden. And from what I know, this is also just a prototype, like a thing to showcase what would be technically possible on an SFF build, but nothing that's listed like in the shop at Case King. But yeah, maybe you can give some feedback down below what you think about this build and the concept. But yeah, quite interesting. So now I hooked up the Mora, which is sitting underneath this table. It's a 420 version. It is absolutely not possible to hear this radiator and pump combination. It's powered by an external PSU, just a simple 12-volt PSU. But let's just switch it on and see what kind of like impressions we can get, what kind of noise level. Yep, I have to admit that's a pretty nice design. Even the logo down there, which is like the King Mod SI, it's like the Case King SI logo, even that is in the right color. Pretty nice. There's one thing I really dislike, but that's just about the case. And the Jonspo case seems to have some kind of like rubber fixtures for the top part. So you put them in and then slide it back, but it just doesn't fit so well, and it also doesn't feel really like high class sliding. It feels, I cannot even really describe it, but it feels like you need a lot of force and then you don't even know where to stop pushing. Yeah, quite weird. With a little less light in my room, pretty nice looking. I think there's just, yeah, too much area around here which is not illuminated in a nice way. So maybe, I'm not sure if it's technically possible, if there's enough space behind it. So if there would be more lights right here, some kind of, I don't know, shape, that would be cool. But apart from that, it's pretty elegant. Hardware wise, it's a 12600K on the C690 iGaming Wi-Fi Strix board, which we already saw, and 32GB of memory and a 3080. At least talking about the contrast to the system, Makita fits pretty well to the system. Meanwhile, a few days later, I got my RS5 back. They changed the brakes on the rear, also changed to summer tires, did oil change and all kind of stuff like that. And right now I'm also on the way to the south of Germany, to Esslingen, which is in the near of Stuttgart, because the team Hardware Reactor Reloaded, which is an overclocking team on HWBot, they organized an overclocking event. Basically, they bought 1400 liters of liquid nitrogen, and then it was like free to join. Well, not free to join, but you had to pay like 150 euro to be there on site and have access to as much LN2 as you want. And there are some people I haven't seen for I don't know how many years, like Frank Bullshooter, for example, Searchman. Those guys I haven't seen for ages. That's why I decided to drive there. It's like 600 kilometers, but yeah, should definitely be fun. Decided to take some GPUs with me. I got the 3090 Ti, the one which we changed from the AIO cooling to the custom water cooling. We might want to mod this card to put it under liquid nitrogen, not sure about that. And then I also got this 1600 XT Strix. Yeah. Hope this survives the journey. Almost there, it's only about 1 hour to go, and then I should be there. It looks like I'm in the right location. At least I spotted something on the left here. Yep, quite sure that I'm in the right space here. For the overclocking event, I will just dub some of these scenes because obviously I cannot do dual anchorage in every situation. But when I arrived, I was wondering, not sure if that's the correct, like, safe way of handling LN2. But anyway, was pretty nice just to see this scene. And yeah, this is exactly how I remember this from like 3, 4, 5 years ago. That's probably the last time that I attended some of these XOC events, and then straight spotted this very obscure liquid nitrogen memory container, which is just built by several plates stuck together with thermal paste, like sealed off by thermal paste, and then use liquid nitrogen, and that's it. Now checking out Bullshooter's system, he was benching some 12600K, and right at the moment when I started recording, obviously the system started failing, and yeah, he was blaming the coarser memory. And again here we had the very special liquid nitrogen memory container. But all I can say is it worked, so it's not stupid. And here the typical situation, which I did not miss on any OC event. So you take all your hardware from your place at home, you bring it to the OC event, and just nothing works. Like no postcode, nothing. Sometimes hilarious situations, but sometimes also quite depressing. At this point I spotted that Searchman beat the current Cinebench R23 record using a 12900KS P-cores only with over 7 GHz.
Auf jeden Fall geile Thermoskanne.
So, ein paar Stunden später. Wenn jetzt wahrscheinlich die 3090 Ti hier mal umbauen auf Physikschickstoff, also das ist die gleiche Karte, die ich mal umgebaut habe auf den Kassenwasserkühler. Und wir haben jetzt keine Kassenwasserkühler. Das heißt, wir werden diese Karte auf diesen Kühler hier umbauen. So, ja, mental verabschiede ich mich jetzt schon mal von dieser Karte. Jo, ansonsten mega cooles Event, hat mir wieder Spaß gemacht, bei so einem XOC-Event dabei zu sein. Also es war für mich jetzt auch, glaube ich, das erste seit 2 oder 3 Jahren. Und da sieht man auch mal wieder, dass eigentlich das, was wirklich Spaß macht, ist halt mit den Leuten zusammen zu sein und sowas zu erleben und auch alte Hardware zu benchen. Also hier geht es nicht darum, irgendwie keine Ahnung, einen neuen 12.900K-Rekord aufzustellen oder sowas, sondern es geht hauptsächlich darum, einfach Hardware zu testen, Spaß zu haben und im Idealfall die 3090 Ti nicht zu töten.
You know what's great about these new 3090 Ti power connectors? When you travel to an event and you forget the adapter. Well, that didn't work out.
Da ist es tatsächlich so, die waren die ersten 5 Minuten schneller.
Das erste Mal mit dem Benchmark überhaupt laufen.
Also die Karte läuft immerhin jetzt mal, die 3090 Ti, takttechnisch ist es noch ein bisschen mau, es sind gerade so bei 2300 MHz, aber man muss auch sagen, dass die Karte komplett ungemoddet ist, das heißt, da sind keine Voltmods oder sonst was drauf, das heißt, wir versuchen jetzt einfach nur rein Temperatur runter und dafür sind es jetzt schon mal so 120, 130 MHz mehr gegenüber dem, was wir mit Wasserkühlung vorher gesehen hatten.
One day after, overclocking event is over. It was very nice to attend an overclocking event again. Right now it's like 5 PM and it has been an extended weekend with bank holiday. So a lot of traffic traveling back to Berlin, so probably like 4 or 5 hours more to go. Then time to cut a video to put this online so you can still watch it by the end of the week. Still hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for tuning in and see you next time. Bye bye.